people get all bent out of shape on what type of finish to put on straw bale or SLC construction. And there's a lot of purists out there who say, well, you gotta use natural products, you gotta go with clay, you gotta go with lime, you gotta go with sand, whatever. I always say build for the climate that you're in. I always say build for the climate that you're in. If you're in Germany, if you're in Saskatchewan, if you're in a climate where you get driving rains, freezing snow, weather conditions that go up and down between plus 30 and minus 30 degrees Celsius, doing a natural finish doesn't stand up very well. You're going to be doing a lot of refinishing work over the years to come. So I kind of look at my wife and I as being a little bit more on the, I don't want to say lazy side, but when I'm 70 years old, I don't want to be out patching my straw bale house. We're building a house to last for our generation as well as our kids' generation and the generations to come. And that means that we're going to put on products that are going to work well for the climates that we live in. So what we've done is we've gone through a lot of different recipes. We've tried everything from pure natural to pure straight off the store shelf. And what we've come up with is a nice mix. So I'll share that recipe with you today. It's extremely simple, and that's another reason why we like it. Keep it simple and make it sure that it works. So what we do is we use just general purpose cement, type 10 or GU, depending on what part of the world that you're buying cement in, and hydrated lime. Now with the hydrated lime, it can be type S or it can be type N. We've used both of them. Both of them work well. Some people say that you should take your lime, you should soak it in water, you should make lime putty out of it. We don't bother with any of that. Keep it simple. So without further ado, here's our top secret recipe to be shared with all of you guys. 3, 2, 1. Doesn't get any simpler than that. 3 parts of sand, 2 parts of cement, and 1 part of lime. And what that does is that gives you a very robust, very tough finish that's still breathable. It's good for natural construction, so if you've got straw bale or SLC, it'll still allow your walls to breathe enough so that they will stay dry in the wet parts of the year, and will still stand up to the freezing temperatures and the heat and the rain as well. So again, that's 3 parts sand, 2 parts general purpose cement, and 1 part lime. Now we will take a variation on this, and we've tried all sorts of playing around with it to see what we like, and that is what we use for a scratch coat. Now, if you're looking for a softer finish and you're looking for something that has a little bit more of a buttery feel and doesn't crack nearly as easy, then what you can do is you can reverse those ratios around. So you still go with 3 parts of sand, 2 parts of lime, and 1 part of cement. So that'll give you a much more buttery texture, makes it very easy to spread. It makes it so that if you do have any areas that have any shift or movement in there, the lime is a little bit more elastic than the cement is, and it will allow that shift to happen, but it makes for a very weak finish. So if you have kids who have a tendency to kick soccer balls at your building, you're gonna end up having damage to your finish. With a finish like that, you can take your hand and you can rub it along and you'll rub some of the sand off. So just to make you aware that if you do reverse those around, it comes with some consequences. So what we like to do, 2 parts cement, 1 part lime to 3 parts of sand. Now, as far as putting it on with a machine or putting it on by hand, I personally prefer putting it on by hand. Some people will go through putting it on with a machine. I find that to be actually slower than hand troweling. The reason for that is because if you've got a crew of people, then using a machine is faster. One person sprays it on, another person comes behind, knocks it down with a trowel. If you're doing it by yourself, it's going to take you longer because you have to pick it up, put it down, pick it up, put it down. You pick up your sprayer, you spray for a bit, You come with your trowel, you knock it all down, you go on, you spray your next area, put it down, pick up your trowel, knock it down again. So whereas if you're troweling it on, works much better. The other thing that I like about troweling is that when you're initially putting it on, you can really push it into the straw and get a really good bond that way. All right, so we're ready to get going doing our mix here. So what I've done is I found a pail, measured out how many shovels of sand fits in there, and then I use that for my recipe so that everything works out to be that 3-2-1 ratio. So here we go. We're gonna throw in about 4.5 gallons of water. And we'll get our mixer going. Throw in our lime. Lime is caustic, so is cement, so you want to be careful that you don't get this coming back in your face and you're breathing it in or getting it in your eyes. As well, if you get any on any exposed skin, wash it off, because if it sits on there, especially the tender part of your arms, it's going to leave burns behind. In goes our cement. And our sand. And we'll let that spin up for a while. After a minute or two, this is what we've got. This is our first mix that we've got coming up here, and you can see how it's slumping over. That's a really nice consistency, and that's what you're looking for. You want it so that it'll hold its own, but it's still very spreadable. So the way I kind of equate it is sort of like smooth peanut butter. Now before we get going and pour our stucco, a good rule of thumb is to wet down all of your tools you're going to be using. If you put water on it, what that'll do is that'll just help clean up at the end of the day a little bit easier. Kind of doesn't make sense if you just wet your tools that it should do that, but it actually does make a huge difference. It just seems like if you've got a dry wheelbarrow, a dry hawk, and a dry trowel, everything just kind of sticks really hard to it right off the bat, and it just continues to go south for the rest of the day. So make sure you wet all your tools down before you get going. The other thing is that any of the surfaces that you're going to be putting stucco on, it's going to, the straw is dry, so it's going to suck all the moisture in from the stucco, and it's going to cause it to crack immediately as it dries out. It's going to dry way too fast. You're going to get a soft, crumbly surface when it finishes or when it dries. And so you want to make sure that you've got wet bonding to wet. And that way it just takes a little longer for the lime and the cement to set up, and it gives it a good time to solidify. So make sure you wet your surfaces down, and you gotta put a good amount of water on there. Not enough to wash the straw out of your walls, but enough that they're going to stay wet for the next couple of hours. So I'm just gonna turn on the pump here so it'll get a little noisy, and spray the walls down just so you guys can see how much water actually goes on. So let's talk about the tools that we're going to use for putting stucco onto our SLC. There's a couple of basic ones that I like to use. One is a mudding hawk. Now this is just a hawk that is used for doing gyp rock taping mudding, and I find that works just fine. I bought this from Home Depot. I think it was about $15, $20 or something like that. I've used it for about 3 years. They stand up well. Another one that I like to use is a 14-inch steel trowel, and this has got very little flex in it. It's very stiff and rigid, and the reason I like that is because it's a nice size for my muscular strength to push it into the straw and to get the first initial coat on. Now, as the subsequent coats of stucco go on, so this is for the scratch coat, and we're going to do a brown coat, and where that brown coat is going to be used just to thicken it up a little bit, fill in any imperfections in our wall, make it nice and smooth, and then we go on to our finishing coat. So with our brown coat and our scratch coat, I like to use this one. Sometimes with the brown coat, I'll switch over onto my finishing trowel, but for the most part, I use this one as my bread and butter every day. For my final coats, I like to use this steel trowel, and this one has a nice curved surface on it. I think about 18 inches in length, something like that. And it's really nice and flexible. And the reason why that's important on your finishing coats is you can really push in and it'll just flow out nice and smooth, gives you a nice wide edge to work with. And because we're not pushing right into the straw, you don't need that extra force pushing in to grab onto it. So this is just for smoothing the icing out on the cake for your final coats. Okay, so we're ready to start putting stucco on now, and so you can see I've got my hawk loaded up. I like to put on about 5 big scoops on there. That's about 15 to 20 pounds worth of stucco. There's no rule that says you got to have this much or that much, whatever. It's whatever you're comfortable with your muscular strength. If it's too heavy, you're going to be fatigued and you're going to wear out very quickly in the day, so work yourself into it and do whatever you can with the strength that you have. Again, that's why I use the size of trowel that I do. This works very well for the muscles that I have. If you find that it's just too much work, too hard, go to a smaller trowel. If you find it too easy or it's taking too long to fill the wall, go to a wider trowel. So it's more figuring it out and see what works for you. The other thing that I'm going to show you here a little later on is on this particular piece of wood, I don't have any mesh tying on. Whenever you have unlike materials, like straw and wood, is going to crack right along that seam. And the reason I don't have anything tying in here is because I'm going to take the stucco up to it, finish it off against the wood. We're going to have another room tying on that's going to be wood frame construction. So there won't be any stucco going onto there. On the rest of it, where we have exposed wood, we have metal mesh tying across, and it ties the straw to the straw with the wood in between. That way, when the wood swells and shrinks with the changing humidity, we don't have any cracking coming into our finish. So to get started, what we're going to do, we're going to bite off a nice bite-sized portion. We're going to push it on, and then you're going to push up and smear it on. Now, something else I should mention is that it's a really good idea just to take some loose straw, throw it down on the ground where you're working. And the reason for that is because it's going to fall off. You're going to have some that is messy and just clumps off. What you do with that is you can pick it up if it's on straw, and you can use it to fill in any holes or patch jobs that you have anywhere along the line. So again, cut in, push it on, work it up. That's how fast it is. here we go. We now have the scratch coat put on. And remember, the whole point behind it is you want to get some protection on that wall. And what the scratch coat is going to do is it's going to bond onto the straw. It's going to show you the high and low points so that on the brown coats, you can fill in any holes that you have, touch up any imperfections. Like here, you can see very clearly that it gouges inward. So we'll take and fill that up, bring that out on the next coats. Here you can see we've got our wood beam structure. We've got 2x2 metal lath tied across, and that's just going to help that from cracking over time. And on the edge over here, where we're going to be building another wood frame structure onto it, I just want to show you what I did. What I did was I took the trowel, pressed it in against the wood, and then curved it, wrapped it around. And so on each coat from this point forward, as I get to the finishing stages, it's just going to keep getting further and further out until it's almost flush with that wood. And what we're going to end up doing then is take a good sealant caulking and just run a bead along there so that we don't have any air infiltration from having different materials put together. So make sure that anything on your ledge that you drop down gets cleaned up along here. You want to make sure that you've got a nice clean edge before you take off. Once that stucco sets up, it's hard as rock, and that's going to affect all of your other layers to come. Anything that you spill down on the ground over here, pick it up in the straw. And again, like I said, any holes or anything that you need to build out works great. Here's an example right here. I knew I've got a piece of wood frame structure that runs in behind, and I knew that I had a hole here, so anything that fell on the ground, I just picked up the handfuls, stuffed it in there. And you just fill it as you go. And the very last thing, I know I'm going to get a bunch of comments on this about spraying versus hand troweling. And the one thing that I want to point out about spraying is, I mean, there's commercial groups that do it all over the place, and it's wonderful. For the guy making his own house at home, the equipment is extremely expensive. It's extremely noisy. You really need to have at least 3 guys on your crew to do it well. Otherwise, it really is slow if you're trying to do it by yourself. And the final thing is that all of your materials have to be sifted so fine. So you can't have any impurities in your sand, otherwise it'll just plug up your sprayer. And so you have to sift out all of your sand, make sure you get any rocks out. Whereas if you're doing it this way with a hand trowel, if you do get the occasional stone in your sand, well, it's no big deal. You feel that as soon as you put it onto the wall, and you can grab it and throw it out, and away you go. So please don't send me any comments on which way is better. This is one method. There's all sorts of ways of applying stucco. This is just one of the ones that that we do. So thanks guys for watching. I hope you learned something from this. Please shoot me some comments, subscribe to us, follow us, and watch us finish building our house. Take care. All right, I lied, guys. I can't let you go quite that quick. There's one more thing, one very important thing that I failed to mention to you guys before in the video, and that is a brush. So whether you like a brushed surface or not, on your initial coats of stucco, all the way up to your finishing coat, you gotta make sure that after your stucco is dry enough that you can't push it in, but it's still damp to the touch. So once it's starting to set, make sure you take a brush, make sure you take something with some teeth on it, and go through and just destroy the surface on there. Rough it up, because otherwise what will happen is when this cement-based stucco cures, you're going to have a very glossy surface, and especially once if you trowel over it, what that's going to do is that's going to bring all the gloss to the surface, and all of your brown and finishing coats are not going to stick. So very important, make sure you destroy the surface, roughen it up with some type of a brush, and that way any other coats that you do from this point on are going to have something to bond to. Thanks again for watching. Take care. Make sure you subscribe.